a top lane video of him, in which I did pretty well. He of course is a champion who was built for the top lane, so he is described as a bruiser. Collapsing top. As a bruiser or a straight up tank. And his overall kit is meant to fulfill this role. Now, this guy has a really a cool gimmick in which he is able to transform into a bigger, monstrous version of himself. And that's that's the Mini Gnar, which you are the default mode, and the Mega Gnar. The Mega Gnar gains a lot of bruiser type abilities and tank abilities, while the Mini Gnar is more mobile, has a longer range on his auto attacks, more attack speed, so he's more mobile in that regard. And you can see there you have a passive called Rage Gene, which gives you fury as you are in combat, and when it gets to 100%, it's when you can transform. Now the transformation can occur instantly if you press an ability, or it will take a couple of seconds after you hit 100 to actually transform. So we'll see how that we'll see that in a minute. You will see transformation, and the reason why he can be played as a jungler is because he has a pretty awesome passive on the W, which will give you additional damage on your every third attack based on the target's maximum health. So that destroys jungle monsters quite fast. Tank it! Why aren't you tanking this for me? Tank it a few hits. There it is. Thank you. Oh, that's a ton of damage. Thank you for that, team. Excellent. We got this pretty quickly. And the rest of his abilities are pretty awesome as well, but this is the one that makes him an awesome, well, not an awesome, but a decent jungler, or a decent clear of the jungle. So for his first ability as the little Gnar here is your boomerang. You saw me there, I just threw it. And basically what it does is it gives you a really long range skill shot that it will hit a target and it will turn back as soon as it hits it, so it will not actually hit a lot of minions and stuff like that. It will just hit and maybe do a small AoE around that and go back. If you catch it, you have reduced cooldown on the ability again, which is awesome. I'm going straight to the red buff, which is awesome, and I highly recommend you do this. Catch it every time you can. We got first blood in the mid lane. That's awesome. The ability does slow, and it's as the laning Gnar, it's an excellent ability for harassing and farming from afar. In the jungle, I just take one point to it, and I don't really max it. You know what? Top is pushing a lot, so I'm gonna concentrate on farming this, getting that level 4. So I'm gonna get an extra point into the W here, so it's faster. Good job. And when you're the Mega Gnar, it actually throws a boulder, which you can also pick up, and it will reduce the cooldown again, and it will actually do a good amount of damage. I should be kiting here a little bit. There it is. One thing I didn't mention about the boomerang, it does reduce damage to the subsequent targets that you hit by 50%, and you cannot hit a target multiple times. So it's only one hit per target, and that's pretty much it. The next ability, I already talked about the three hit passive, and when you actually gain, not only do you gain the damage on the target, you also gain a burst of speed, which is pretty awesome. And the Mega Gnar gives you we're gonna cast it right now, a line skill shot that stuns enemies and it scales off AD. And since I will be maxing this first, it will actually give me a good amount of damage and low cooldown on this when I transform. So pretty awesome to have this at your disposal. And your next ability is your E. Your E is a small leap that gives you attack speed when you're in the Mini Gnar form. And you also are able to jump additionally, so you've hit a unit. It doesn't have to be a ally unit or enemy unit. It can be any type of unit. You will gain a little bit more jump. There it is. And the second jump actually gives you... has a scaling, HP scaling on the damage. So that's pretty awesome to have on the ability. Although it's pretty hard to aim, you have it there, and it's important that you do. And when you're the Big Gnar, it's just a regular jump that will do damage based on your max health as well, and it will slow enemies around yourself. So that's pretty awesome to have. He's about to transform, but we can probably do something here. Here we go. Oh, nice jump there. You have excellent chasing. No, go in here. Go in here. He's about to transform, dude. It took too long to help me, so we're done. I got him pretty low, so that's good. Your ganks are not the best, at least early on, and you need to do a good job of balancing out the your fury meter, your rage here, so you can actually transform in the appropriate time, which is not easy. I want to try out. I really like going tanky in this game, and I think I'm gonna go tanky because we don't have a tank in this game. We need me to be tanky, so I'm gonna go straight up to the Spirit of the Ancient Golem, and I'll get damage after that, and I will probably get a Giant's Belt after I get some AD because you want to use synergy with the Ancient Golem as well. I have seen people go with Wriggles Lantern on him. It works.